Hey, some random person here, back with more XCOM 2 War of the Chosen gameplay. Where we left off, we just finished preparing to finally investigate the Advent Black Site. We had to do this at some point. Honestly, I probably should have done it earlier, but we have to do it now because we've got less than 3 weeks until the Avatar project is complete. And then who knows what's going to happen from there. Well, I know, because I've played through this game multiple times, and I'm assuming War of the Chosen doesn't radically alter the story in that regard. But viewers who aren't familiar with the game won't know, and we're just gonna keep playing as though we don't. Plus, because I don't know if some things might change. Some things might have been changed a lot. Like, for example, not necessarily story related, but these story missions, like Blacksite. Oh, there's Central.
The aliens worked hard to keep this place under the radar, and we don't know what we're gonna find in there. Keep your heads up. Expect heavy opposition.
So this is, I'm not sure if it was in vanilla, if it was on a specific map, or if it was just very small set of map of terrain parcels that it could use. Either way, it was basically the same map every time. I'm not sure, but I wouldn't be surprised if they've changed that for War of the Chosen. Oh yeah, looking at the weird alien plant life. Yeah, they've changed the map a bit.
We've confirmed the black site is in your immediate vicinity. Infiltrate and investigate the area. Expect heavy resistance. Neutralize all hostile contacts.
They may have just reskinned it, actually. It looks fairly similar to how I'd normally done it. Looks fairly similar to the vanilla version, I mean. Alright. Start sending out Ryder.
Moving out.
To go scout ahead. There's a turret. Let's just not worry about the turrets. Just don't bother with the turrets if we don't have to. It's not like they're gonna move to detect detect the squad.
10-4.
So long as we stay out of their range, out of their detection range, we'll be fine.
Agreed distance.
Just have everyone dash.
Double time.
So we don't have to. There's no need for us to stick around and fight every alien we see. Our goal is to get into the black site proper, find anything of value that we can take, and get out.
Yes, Commander.
Hold on, are those
bodies?
Oh yeah, these pods are full of
the containers,
bodies.
The trains.
There's a couple Vipers over there.
The aliens are still abducting people. From the looks of it, they may never have stopped after the invasion.
Those containers look like they have self-contained power cells. It could be some kind of stasis system. It's possible at least some of those people might still be alive.
Here is the main black site building. There's gonna be a turret or two on top of it, I'm sure. There always have been in vanilla. I'm sure they haven't changed that. Let's go around these pods. It's full cover. It's high cover, rather. There's gotta be some more enemies around here. There's gonna be a group inside, I'm sure.
As you order.
If I'm remembering from vanilla, no matter when I played this mission in vanilla, and I've done it at all sorts of different points, but I usually try to do it early. I put this one off a bit too long, I think. There was always a group of enemies with some variant on the Advent mech in there, I don't know if any of these groups are guaranteed, or if it's just like at the points that I was normally going in at, there were you were just more likely to see that. Oh. Okay. Yeah, enemies that will sometimes just shoot at flanked soldiers when they spot them.
I'm taking fire.
This does mean that they don't run for cover, though. So it gives us an opportunity to just to just wreck them, just destroy them right here. So yeah, you did some damage, but now you're totally open. Let's try. Let's just use Wrath just for fun.
Advent has expanded their rail network to touch every city center they've built, and this looks like the end of the line, at least for this area.
Oh yeah, there's a turret over there. All right, now that Mox has done some damage, he's gonna get out. Break line of sight with them. We've got Outrider. We don't need our Phantom Ranger to stay concealed, really. He can throw his axe. I think I'd like to have Scorch rend.
You will pay the price!
Because I believe no matter where she is, she's gonna be into the turret. I just wanted to get her behind high cover. Ooh, Illyrium core and alien data cache. Nice. I'll probably just end up selling that data cache at the black market, honestly. But I might not. I probably will, though. I think this breaks line of sight with the turret, actually. If not, she's still in high cover, and thus we're still going to be fine. Now this Viper is going to be stunned for her next turn, so she won't be able to even do anything. Let's get Outrider over here. Let's check out what's inside. See in there? Nothing yet. Yeah, the Viper's not going to be able to do anything right now, so I feel totally fine just having everyone run away. Ah, okay, that gets him sight into the sight.
Processed with such brutal efficiency. Test subjects for some sort of weapon.
Trigger that cutscene next turn.
Looks more like a refinery to me, Doctor.
Once we get our hands on that sample, we'll know for sure.
Yeah, see that weird vial there? We're gonna go steal it.
Location confirmed!
I might have Scorch go finish off that Viper next turn so she can get up to max focus and then have her run back to join the others. Oh, whoops. Outrider. We'll just overwatch for now. Ow. Alright. Here's the assassin. Maybe we'll get a chance to kill her. We've killed her brothers both at least once. Well, like two or three times for the Warlock and just once for the Hunter, because we've only met him once. She can summon Stomlancers now. And is it just weird or the weapons look a bit different? She might have upgraded. Anyway.
At the very least, you will die with honor.
I think we might have a decent shot at her.
Heads up out there. It's the Elder's assassin, and she's moving into the AO.
I recently learned through the little tips that the game shows you on loading screens that if this mission had a timer, that this would be kind of important.
There will be no
mission
escape.
Timers get paused when you engage the Chosen. So you get all, you get any time you need to fight them. So if I'm scorched, just finish this Viper. Got that 2 focus. According to target preview, she can't. She doesn't have line of sight to the turret. If it turns out that she can't get targeted by the turret, though, can't just. Looks like she can. She'll be fine. I was gonna say that we could just teamwork, give her another move. Oh, there's that Advent alloy padding there. So that's just a normal trooper. So there's a trooper, a mech. The mech has 3 armor. So I guess the Advent alloy padding doesn't just give their standard trooper's armor.
What's over there?
And move Hurricane over here. Hopefully they stay relatively close together. There's just 2 normal troopers there. Okay. Yeah, I wanted them to stay kind of close together so we could use the rocket launcher. 4-7 damage, and I think it's got 2 shredding. Yeah, so there's 1 trooper dead. A mech. Close to death, really.
Not all are created equal.
And then a trooper exposed. That's great. Mox will dash up to join the rest of the squad. Outrider
says I am to obey.
Will run in. Make sure there's no other enemies in the way. And then see what her shots look like. 50% chance to reveal. Come on, RNG. Work with us here.
The only fate possible for aliens.
Oh, that must have hit like 51%. It's not vital, really. It's not really vital to my strategy or anything that she not be revealed. I just prefer keeping her in shadow for that sweet mobility boost, among other things.
That's affirmative.
Alright, where are others? Yeah, we'll need to wait for Scorch and Mox.
Got it covered.
To get closer. Oh, is that a... that's a purifier. A priest, purifier, and a shield bearer. Ugh. And they're all coming around the side. Assassin gonna show herself? Oh, she's somewhere in there, I think. Are they? No, they're not close enough for bolting. I think I'm gonna.
Okay, I'll go.
Is it clear?
I'm gonna try to wait for them to enter the building.
I run.
There will be no reconciliation for your kind, betrayer. Fight and die with honor, or simply die. It makes no difference to me.
Check our items. Scorch. We'll just have to run over here.
I'll lead the way.
might just shoot after going on Overwatch. I don't want that. Put you on Overwatch.
Covering now.
Give me time to reload.
Have you have Outrider reload. And then we'll have her re-enter Shadow.
I am the hunter.
Hurricane. No, there's nothing to shoot at, so I'll try an Overwatch. Outrider, we'll do an Overwatch just in case. And then, because we're all grouped up here. How many can I get? Man, I'd love to be able to get everyone but Outrider, but it looks like I can get everyone but Torch and or Mox. Look, everyone but Torch and Outrider. It's Outrider, hopefully she won't even be seen. I'll go with this one. Figure I might as well use the smoke grenade if we have it, plus if the assassin's nearby, it'll really help if she has a harder time hitting people. Advent, I bet they're running around. Come in. Oh, she's close. There she is.
I had hoped your kind would never stumble across this facility, Commander. Some things are best left unknown.
I wonder if you're just I wonder if it's just like scripted that you get a chosen fight in the black site. It wouldn't surprise me. She doesn't even know that. Doesn't even know that Outrider's right behind her.
The trap is set.
Throw the claymore. See what she can do with the vector rifle. Let's not do that though. Do a chain reaction explosion frag grenade.
This usually works.
Plus the claymore. 11 damage in one turn. One attack, really. Hey, if the explosives work, who needs nuance when you can just blow everything up? That's why I brought two grenadiers on this mission. Just in case I needed to blow up more stuff. How much damage could I do? Oh, so close to a rend kill. Mox has an 80%. He is close though, so he can. So that makes sense. Let's see. See if Mox can help you out. Oh, and he's zeroed in. And Bewildered has kicked in. We'll kick in with this shot, so down goes the assassin for the first time. Sweet. Alright, now there's just the priest and purifier and shield bearer.
The elders will not allow me to die in this world. We will meet again.
I'd say we owe our people a break after taking down that commander. I doubt it'll be long before we see that thing again, though.
What's over there?
Alright, we gotta start. We gotta keep everyone moving. Keep everyone moving towards the objective.
You heard the doctor.
And see the vial.
That canister.
And it looked like we could briefly see a muton over there.
Pistol Overwatch.
Overwatch. Oh, overly aggressive. Aggressive, what is she shooting at?
We put our soldiers through a lot. They'll need time to deal with these issues when we get back.
Oh. Okay. So he sees Outrider now. This is that grenade. It was kind of pointless for me putting her back in shadow, I guess, if I was going to do that grenade. But hey, she's getting stasis and not getting shot. That could be worse. Alright, so we know that they're all grouped up out there. So I think if they're all like right outside the window, we might be able to just hit them all with a flashbang. That should activate them and just screw them up. Oh, it just hit the priest. It'd be cool if that ended stasis. Oh, it doesn't activate. Okay.
I guess that'll be okay.
Guess we'll have to try to force it through other means. Can we grapple up and get above? No. Let's just have Mox get a bit closer and then reload.
I am reloading.
And then Ranger.
You'll join me.
I'd really rather not activate them right now. I want them to just wander in. Nothing to shoot at, so... Is she gonna be aggressive towards nothing at all? Does it just, like, cancel out Overwatch? Okay.
Moving to
Could
Overwatch.
Be worse.
I rolled up waiver.
Moving to Overwatch.
Alright, stasis is over. The priest is disoriented, though, so...
It's getting ugly.
He's still not gonna... Okay. There they are. Just that shield bearer. He already shielded everyone though. And
come on, focus.
Not good.
Oh, that one hurt.
Can that purifier get in close to flame? Oh, that is downright dastardly.
I can see them flanking!
He's moving around to flank us with the flamethrower. But it doesn't work. Those Overwatches hit. Just blew up like the whole front of this facility. But it works.
Fire spreading!
Whatever works. Alright.
Go.
Are we seeing freaking we got enough crap to deal with, and now we got a Spectre and mutons. Just gonna try to get some shredding and cover destruction done. Got through the cover. That worked. Mox can use Wrath on the mutons. That's not the best move I don't think. Can do a free whiplash. The thing I really want to do though is just kill shield bearer. We can use wrath on either of them. We can also use justice on the priest, but not on the shield bearer. Oh, okay. Is there anywhere that lets him see the stupid shield? That lets people see the stupid shield bearer? We got a remote start somewhere? Oh, that's not a bad remote start at all. I'm taking watch this opportunity closely. While we've got it. There goes Muton. Grapple.
I take a new approach.
See if we can see anything interesting up here. Okay, there is no turret. I thought for sure there'd be a turret. But now we can whiplash the shield bearer. And it's free, so even if it doesn't work, it did.
It did not stop them.
Advanced priests have quite a lot of health, actually. I think I'm gonna see what's his mobility looking like. First off, I was thinking about activating Reaper, but no, I'm just gonna rend. So that gets rid of the shield. We're gonna blow up this wall. Sudden lag spike. That does something, at least. I'm gonna move
moving on target location.
Up closer, actually. Closer to the mutons. And then he'll throw the mimic beacon. Got a momentum move available. How much can Mox do with a rip jack, with a bolt pump shot? Or he can use justice, or use wrath, but wrath would leave him exposed. Justice could let him stun. I think I'm just gonna shoot though. Dodge. Okay. Something at least. Hey, and I get AP. Getting more AP is always nice. Scorch. Just run over here, I guess. Okay, he's no longer disoriented. Maybe he'll try some Psy shenanigans. Mind controlling Mox? Oh. Okay, so advanced priests get mind control.
I was created to serve the elders.
The Spectre just vanished. That's not good. I mean, the Spectre vanishing, not the Muton shooting the Mimic Beacon. That's great. That's exactly what I wanted to see. I was just kind of hoping the Spectre would maybe do the same, and maybe the Priest too. Scorch.
Feel the power of the Templar.
Go free, Mox. Alright, Mox is back. Alright, so the Mimic Beacon worked like a charm. Oh wait, that was the wrong unit. No, it still works. I did mean to have our Ranger move around, but hopefully one shot.
Gonna need to reload soon.
But this works too.
I'm trusting you here.
I don't want to risk using Wrath on a Muton because it might get countered.
As you command.
Outriders at 1 HP. This is still ugly. 79%. Let's do it. Sweet.
For the free. No ammo.
My life is in your hands.
Still don't know where the stupid Spectre is. So there's a door here. So once we grab the vial, we're just gonna have whoever has it run out here and get to the evac, to the extraction point.
Okay, I'll go.
And I feel like the one to take the vial should be Outrider, just because she's already at 1 HP. And so she needs to get out fast.
Okay.
Let's put our Ranger out by the door. Alright, Spectre is revealing himself. Where's he going? What's he doing?
The aliens have claimed another. We welcome death.
Oh, he's shadowbound Outrider. So now there's an Outrider ghost that's gonna go take cover. Hopefully we can kill the Spectre pretty quickly, otherwise that ghost might be a problem. But we can kill the ghost itself. That'll work just as well to get rid of it. Alright, change of plans here. We're gonna run and gun. Dash over here. I was planning on just having him pop open the door. But no, he's just gonna one-shot the Spectre.
Target neutralized.
Just gonna one-shot crit the Spectre. So then the ghost, the shadow, I mean, goes away. And Outrider is no longer shadowbound.
I go where I am needed.
Just gonna run over here. And grab the vial. Purification Centrifuge. Interesting name.
Your material is secure.
Alright, so she's grabbing the vial. And there's gonna be reinforcements coming.
Shen, any readings?
No signs of radioactivity. No significant energy signatures of any kind. Whatever it is, it's safe to handle.
They put the thing on this.
Acquisition of the sample. Move to rendezvous at the extraction point.
So they put the thing on this weird pedestal in this secret facility, but they just have it come out after all these weird things just kind of descend into whatever the heck this fluid is. It could be water, it could be something else entirely, I don't know, not sure I want to know. It just seems a little unnecessary, a little over the top.
That
Alright, Outrider's gonna be gone soon, so I'm just gonna have Mox use teamwork to give her a boost, get her a bit closer to extraction.
Moving out.
Torch. You're also gonna run out.
I hope it's worth it.
It's the reinforcements. What I'm used to, I'm used to the reinforcements coming in closer to the extraction point. So I very much welcome the reinforcements coming on the other side of this of the facility. And that's two troopers and a purifier. Looks like maybe a normal trooper, an advanced trooper, and a purifier.
Advent troops here!
Or no, two advanced troopers and one purifier. Maybe just a normal purifier or advanced, I'm not sure. I'm losing track. It doesn't matter, you get the point. Can Mox grapple anywhere to get a bit closer? No, he can't. Maybe... he's outside? No, there's no grappleable surfaces. I'm just gonna move over to the other side here. Our ranger needs to get moving. Our Templar can get out. We've got a few people that can just get out already.
Move, move, move!
In short order.
They're all out that way. Sadly, we can't jump out this window. We're definitely sending Outrider. I'm gonna leave the others here. I'm gonna leave the others in just a little bit. Still at full health. So, Coyote, you can sponge some bullets if you have to. And then we're just gonna end the turn. Nice shot there, trooper. Purifier's not even close, not even anywhere near close enough. Another nice shot. Coyote, how close can you get?
Copy that.
Pretty dang close. Everyone else.
A long run.
If you say so.
Alright. Everyone else, there's...
leaving combat.
These others,
I'm
there's
out.
Nowhere... no way they're getting
I'm gone.
Close enough.
Heading home.
So everyone else is just gonna escape now. Coyote, you're all alone. Don't die. And just wait. Suddenly, like, a whole squad of stun lancers comes out and all just start... repeatedly just chain stunning him. Somehow they do less damage, but now they're just constantly stunning. Be perfect.
Moving out.
Perfect end to this, right? Though it does have Bladestorm, so that would be pretty cool to see. Alright. Anyway, enough with my dumb hypothetical scenarios, we're getting out of here.
All XCOM operatives are secure.
Because this was a fairly good black site, aside from Outrider almost dying.
Where it hurts. This was a place no living human being was ever intended to see. Happy as I am to see it gone. Something tells me the aliens won't take this lying down.
Yeah, the aliens won't take this lying down. They definitely won't. But hey, we killed the Chosen! I'm gonna change the poses a bit, actually, because I like how this looks. I kind of like the general setup here with the text, with the humanity's last stand text. Gotta be ready for a fight like the rest of these, like the rest of your squad. Let's see what other, if I want to do another map location. On the roof. Yeah. Could we get one? I wonder if we'd get one like in front of the facility. It's on the roof again. At the extraction point. Sorry I'm spending so much time with this, but this one is, I just like how this one's looking. I'm gonna change Bronx's pose again because I'm not satisfied. Looks like I need to re-rotate everyone though. There.
Pretty sure I saw that on an album cover decades ago.
Ah, two wounds, and Outrider is once again going to be out for like a month, but we've got an infirmary coming up soon, so we'll be able to hasten wound recovery times, plus if we really needed to, we could go scan at Templar HQ.
Up to those who would abandon our values for those of the old world. The remarks followed a moment of silence. Peacekeepers slain by XCOM dissidents.
I mean, it makes sense that they're not going to mention their weird human processing plant that they've got, that they were specifically making sure no one knew about. Apparently they didn't do a very good job, because we found it and we've just stolen whatever the heck was in there. Some promotions on that mission.
Maybe the elders hoped the Chosen's constant jabbering would drive us to surrender without a fight.
Ooh. Ouch. Alright, Outrider's promoted. She's finally hitting Lieutenant. Silent Killer. Kills with a vector rifle. Don't increase the Reaper's chance to break Shadow. Distraction. A kill with the Claymore puts the Reaper into Shadow. And Needle. Shots taken in Shadow have +2 armor piercing. Some XCOM AP now. And her XCOM perk, Kill Zone. Take a reaction shot against any enemy that moves or attacks within a cone of fire. That's 25 AP though. It's kind of expensive. I'm gonna have to spend some AP to get some of these other perks at some point, because I really like these Reaper perks. But I like the idea of Silent Killer. think Scorch and Torchwood, what are they looking like? Not quite ready for level 2 yet. Now we've got almost everyone is tired.
Now that we've recovered the
got our blacksite lot, vial, an auto loader, laser sight, lyrium core, and alien data
cache. The true purpose of this substance. I will begin preparations for a complete analysis immediately, Commander.
Alien data cache decryption.
Seen the inner workings of the blacksite facility. The outcome is perhaps even more troubling than I had expected. It is clear the aliens have undertaken a gruesome task. I will leave this matter for you to investigate, Commander.
All right. Reduced avatar progress by 1.
Mental fatigue starts to impact our soldiers' tactical effectiveness when they don't have a chance to rest. We should give them a few days off to recover if we can manage it.
Okay, so now we've got a shaken soldier, so Hurricane is... we're just not going to be able to take her on missions until she's rested enough.
My kind all possess clouded memories of the facility.
Okay, I was going to explain more, but Bayless is saying something interesting.
It is the place of our birth, and the final march for those humans deceived by the Elders' false promises. In destroying it, we have done this world a great service.
So the Black Site's involved with the creation of Advent. Anyway, back to Shaken. Occasionally, when in vanilla, where Will was nothing like it is now, really, it had nothing to do with the fatigue system or anything like that. Sometimes soldiers that went on, it seemed like if they went on missions that went poorly, like you had deaths or they got gravely wounded or something, could be shaken. So they'd have their will temporarily reduced to zero, so they'd panic at just about everything, and couldn't resist any psionic attacks, like, at all. But if they went on a mission, got a kill, and remained unharmed throughout that mission, they would have their will restored and increased from where it was before. Now, they just can't go on missions for a while. Alright, there's our avatar reduction.
You continue to prove resourceful, Commander. Although you have dealt a blow to the aliens' work by destroying the Black Site, there is still much to be done.
Let's check our dark events for a second. Alright, yeah, they just built a new facility. So we might be okay for avatar project stuff for a while. All the same, I want to finish making contact with New Australia so we have a facility available. So that might actually be what we want to do next, is just hit that facility to get us a bit more breathing, to get us some more breathing room. Got a supply drop coming very shortly.
Incoming message. Oh,
spider
for you,
and
Commander.
Fly expired.
Patching it through to your quarters now.
I had high hopes for the resistance under your leadership, Commander, and you have outdone yourself.
I love how this doesn't at all mention the fact that the Avatar project very nearly completed. Let's check out Chosen activity. So killing her must have put her knowledge back down a bit. The assassin. So, assassin and hunter are both planning retribution, and warlock is sabotage. But hunter's knowledge is just pathetic. The assassin has had plenty of opportunity to collect knowledge. Oh. Huh. Okay. Loyalty among thieves. When any chosen gains information about XCOM, a portion of that is passed along to the assassin as well. And then the collectors. The chosen double their efforts to hunt the commander, seeking to capture XCOM soldiers at every opportunity. Oh, plus a hidden event that I don't want to spend intel on at the moment. But now, we can switch up our resistance orders a bit if we want. I still like Lightning Strike. I really like Quid Pro Quo. Art of War is nice too. I don't think I'm going to change anything. His Hidden Reserves is nice. Soon we'll be able to get put in a Skirmisher order too. So we got a supply drop available, but I'm not going to get it yet. We have 2 more days, and we'll be able
our inspiration
to
did prove beneficial.
Put in skirmisher orders on our next month, and we've got Gauss weapons research complete. So now we've figured out how to make mag cannons, Gauss rifles, temnotic rifles, which are, I think, the yeah, this is the vector rifle upgrade. Gauss rifle, the sniper rifle, and mag cannon, which is a cannon. Ooh. Future Combat 1. Breakthrough. Muton autopsy is instant. A breakthrough in all train and our training methods will reduce the cost of all GTS tactics by 20%. I don't know if I want to do that, but let's just do the Muton autopsy.
Has personally substantiated claims that the massive frontline unit they call the Muton was actually at one time even larger than the specimen I have before me today. As it is, the creature is abnormally warm to the touch for a corpse, and I must say, it is quite disconcerting. The aliens make a strong statement by fielding these massive creatures as their frontline combat units. I doubt they thought anyone would resist when faced with the alternative of staring down a Muton.
So, Mutons, they've been tampered with, they've been genetically modified a lot, just like every other alien really, but Mutons, like, especially, I guess, and they're apparently a tribal culture, with all sorts of weird, like, ritual scarring and tattoos and stuff. More importantly, doing this autopsy gets us advanced grenade launchers, so get longer range and a larger blast radius, and plasma grenade proving ground project. This will let us just, once we do this, it'll just replace all our frag grenades with plasma grenades, which do more damage. They're just a straight upgrade. We want to keep avatar progress down, plus we've got a shielded power coil. So we're gonna start. I'm gonna start alien encryption. Future combat isn't that. Doesn't seem that great.
I'll see that work begins immediately, Commander.
Future
I'll
combat.
I'll contact you when I have a full report available.
Would probably be more useful in vanilla if where there were more GTS tactics to do to get. Oh, we've got our spider suit. It has a grappling hook. Only one utility slot, but it also and adds less health. But it's a grappling hook. I think it gives some dodge and it gives some mobility too.
Looks like.
Yeah, shut up, Hunter. Finally making contact with Australia.
We've managed to track the chosen hunter to this region.
Yeah, I know, we've got our supply drop.
Our soldiers took some hits during the most recent covert action, but word from the medical team is they'll all be fine.
Got a wound, but most importantly, we've hunted the hunter.
Together, we have learned even more about the chosen that pursue you, Commander.
And now we've got some.
By a common enemy,
we've got
and together
some influence
strong
with the skirmishers now. So, we've got new orders and new covert actions.
All skirmishers, all those freed from the Elder's bonds, are eager to hear your commander.
Oh man, this could actually be really good. Sabotage, remove one block of avatar progress at the end of every month. Sweet! Alright, let's assign covert actions.
Our influence with the resistance factions has motivated them to share some new information on the chosen.
Alright, so we've got hunt the assassin, hunt the hunter, and hunt the warlock. We can form the soldier bond, just soldier cohesion meets the next bond threshold. Gather intel, counter retribution, presumably from the assassin. Increase income, new Indonesia income increases by 13 supplies. Recruit an engineer. Counter retribution. Manufacture a superior weapon upgrade. get a facility lead, which if researched we can just find a new facility. Or there's a covert action sabotage to reduce Avatar progress. All this income reduction is getting really it's starting to stack up on us. Do the one with the Reapers, but we're probably going to take a wound. But we could get a promotion for someone. Or we could give someone plus one mobility and have a low wound chance. Let me see who we might want to give a promotion to. Probably one of these corporals. Not sure why it's saying the bond mate, Lieutenant Praedol Mox. That's weird. Whatever. I think we're gonna go with this one, actually. We're gonna send a sharpshooter on that. And then allocate the intel to prevent chosen capture. High risk of wounds, but a promotion will be nice. And if Outrider, yeah, if Outrider wasn't out of action right now, I'd be much more willing to take plus one mobility so she can scout even better. Alright, hold on, I'm gonna go back to the Avenger for a moment. Yeah, I can't spare anyone right now. Get in resistance comms. If we had more power, we could upgrade. All right, yeah, we're just gonna
Avenger
go to the supply drop.
New course.
All right, there's our supply drop. And we can go to this
Avenger
clinic to try to
course.
Get some Avenger power. Extra power is always nice.
Scilab, now operational.
Alright, Scilab is now up and running. Alright, I'm gonna hire a couple rookies. Put someone in. Oh wait, what do we need to do to upgrade? Oh. Actually, I'm gonna get the second cell upgrade right now. Put our engineer in here. Go with armory. Recruit. I'm just gonna pick someone at random from the list. Yeah, pick two rookies, and then put them in here. So then, these two will both be unavailable for 5 days while they undergo side operative training. Oh, we've got our infirmary. Got the infirmary up and running. Staff and engineer to increase healing rate. And then soon negative trait removal. Start getting these worked on. Okay, nothing else is gonna go, so we can keep scanning. Oh! I completely forgot that we had a wounded engineer from chosen sabotage. So this means we can get a couple more resistance contacts. We're low on intel though. so we're not going to be able to do too much with that.
Your interference in my plans may slow, but can never stop the inevitable fate of this world.
Alright. That worked. Alright, let's assign a new covert action. Oh, so this one, it's like the Templars are attacking a facility. That's cool. Could counter another chosen activity. But I think I'm going to... Yeah, I'm gonna put some people in to reduce avatar progress. I don't care who gets an increase in will at the moment. Let's just put a random corporal in. Allocate 25 supplies to negate the risk of soldiers being captured.
My followers will lead this action to victory.
Hopefully, Geist. Aha, we got blue screen protocol finished. Now we can build EMP grenades, which deal a bunch of damage to mechanical and robotic enemies and possibly shutting them down for a short time, for like a turn or two. And blue screen rounds, which are actually one of the most powerful items in the game later on, because there are some very, very difficult, there are some very tough, very threatening mechanical enemies. And these do extra damage to them. Alien encryption complete. Alright, so this is just all figuring out weird stuff with how the heck all this alien encryption stuff works. So now we can build the Shadow Chamber, which is basically the plot progression facility. I think it's about time we finish up some of these autopsies. So let's start
with
Viper.
Although I would expect to be growing more accustomed to seeing the clear intermingling of both human and alien genetic material, I must admit, this reptilian creature with such distinctive human features is surprisingly unsettling. Invasion era reports include references to a species with some reptilian qualities, but nothing as readily apparent as this.
I'll let you decide what for yourselves just what distinctive human features he's talking about.
I've started to wonder how the Advent administration views our current band.
I don't remember
renegades.
How much the Shadow Chamber costs.
Do they see us as an actual threat?
We need about 100 more supplies.
Or more of a nuisance.
New orders, Commander?
The Shadow Chamber takes a lot of power. That and the Psy Lab. I think the Psy Lab takes a lot of power. I've just started building it. I just build it on one of the power coils. I've actually forgotten how much it costs. I know the Shadow Chamber is quite expensive, though.
I've had a chance to take a closer look at some of the Advent weapons recovered from the field.
So we're gonna go to the black market.
Avenger plotting new course.
Try to get some supplies. Pretty interested. Advent datapad, medikit, and mind shield. 70 supplies for an Advent datapad. And I believe we have an alien data cache, so that would give more intel than an Advent datapad. I'm willing to sell this. We've got 77 alloys, 77 delirium crystals. I don't think we actually need muton corpses for anything after we do the autopsy. We've got a spider suit, so I don't need another stun lancer corpse. Shield bearers don't actually do anything, but we need to keep one around for autopsy. Keep the specters. I'll sell one faceless in case, keep a couple corpses around in case we want to make another mimic beacon. Confirm. Go back into the Avenger yet again. and then
maximum power.
Shadow chamber, Commander. We've pushed
get the shadow chamber construction started.
We don't have any capacity to spare, which means we can't expand our facilities further.
Yeah, it'll take 14. It'll take another 2 weeks to get that done if we don't put an engineer on it, but we don't have an engineer to spare right now. Oh, let's see what we can buy at the black market. You can buy chosen warlock information, a lieutenant rank specialist, supplies, some upgrade stuff, resources, rush some autopsies. Nah. Let's go back to this
Avenger
clinic.
Plotting new course.
Counter hidden event. Protect device gives us supplies. Low profile due to heavy surveillance. Only soldiers of rank sergeant or lower are allowed. Neutralize field commander to get 86 intel. Encounters the collectors. Hack the hidden resistance computer to get a lieutenant ranked grenadier. Encounter loyalty among thieves. We need intel. We need supplies too, because I'd like to finish upgrading our weapons. But we can get supplies if we have intel to spend at the black market. And I don't like the idea of the Chosen constantly trying to capture people. So we're gonna go to
setting
this one.
Course for the Arctic territories.
Doubt we'll be seeing the assassin again for a little while, though. Probably won't have to worry much about her. Alright, armor, weapons, utility items available. This is just supposed to be a moderate difficulty. So this poor squatty who's just been going on every covert action but still hasn't gotten a promotion. We'll bring her along so she can at least say that she's been helping. Let's bring a specialist. Alright, her game is shaken. 2 days. Overdrive hasn't been on a mission in a while. Let's bring her home. No way, we don't need 2 specialists. What am I thinking? DEFCON. Get a hunter. What am I thinking? I saw the name hunter. Like, grenadier. I'm gonna bring Scorch again, just because I have so much fun using her. I can't bring Torch, though, because Torch is recovering from a negative trait. Stinger. Have more melee. I've got a bunch of specialists. I take 2 grenadiers on every mission, so of course they're getting wounded all the time. Actually, I'm curious, what's our class balance look like? 4 grenadiers, 3 rangers, 2 psi operatives, 2 sharpshooters, and 5 specialists. Yeah, we have too many specialists. So, you know, we'll take Thomas Harris. We'll take this guy on here too. Why not? I'm just gonna arbitrarily decide. You're gonna be the hacker. I'll remember that because you have the Skulljack. Even though you're not gonna be able to use it, it doesn't really do anything for you. You get the medikit. You'll be our healer. Actually, no. Well, Skulljack, I don't think it gives you anything at the moment. Yeah, it shouldn't give you anything. Yeah, we don't have skull mining. So, forget what I just said. Let's get her something actually useful. Like a frag grenade for the moment. She we'll also get the bolt caster. Sniper rifle. And we'll give you the Shadow Keeper.
This one is sighted in. There's no excuse for missed shots.
I haven't taken a sharpshooter on a mission in a while. We'll give you the spider suit too. I like giving sharpshooters a spider suit.
The spider suit will improve our soldiers' chances of dodging an attack, while also providing increased agility and grappling.
Spider suit's nice on a sharpshooter because it helps them just get where they need to go.